Sometimes when we sign into Windows, we get this error message. There, you see it? That's just a simulation. I don't actually have this come up for me anymore. But this is what it looks like. So let's get rid of it. Most of the tutorials will tell you to go into Shared Experiences settings, and then you have to turn off Nearby Sharing and turn off Share Across Devices and stuff like that. But of course, if you're watching this video, it's because that hasn't worked yet. Now, it says for me that this works right now, but you know, usually there's some kind of an error here. Or even if there's not an error here and you still are getting this notification, then I'll show you what worked for me. So I'll close this. Now, before you do any of this stuff, make sure you write down your Microsoft account password and your local account password. Obviously, you'll destroy this piece of paper later, but just in case you need it, you don't want to get caught out later if you're blocked out of signing into Windows because they're expecting your local account password or they're expecting your Microsoft account password. You need to know what that is, otherwise it'll be difficult. You can restore it, but that's a pain, right? So to avoid that, then just write it down. And once you're comfortable that you've got everything set up and it's behaving as expected, then you should destroy that piece of paper. We'll click the Windows icon in the corner, click on my user icon, and go to Change Account Settings. So here you see it says Manage My Microsoft Account. And what that means is that I'm actually signed into Windows using a Microsoft account. But you can sign in with a local account instead. You don't actually require a Microsoft account to use Windows. They just really want you to have one. So let's click this, sign in with a local account instead. And here we see them begging, please don't go. So I'll go ahead and hit next, making sure it's you. So we go ahead and enter a username and then a password. You do have to enter a password hint and then hit next. Then I'll hit sign out and finish. Now, if it says something has happened and your PIN isn't available, in my case, this is because I did everything I could to avoid setting one up. You don't have to hit setup PIN. You can just pick sign in options and choose the key icon to enter a password, and that's it. So enter your password. God damn it. So now we're back in. I'll click the Windows icon and go to my user icon, my username, and then change account settings. And now you see that it says sign in with a Microsoft account instead. Just to double check everything, let's go to search for a setting, type in shared, and then come down to shared experience settings. And you see that everything is still turned off. And here it also says all accounts are working correctly. Now, since I've done this, I haven't received any of these notifications anymore. So I hope that worked out for you. You still have your Microsoft account, of course, but you need to go online to change its settings. It might even be the case that simply going through this process of signing in with the local account and then re-signing in with the Microsoft account could get the notification to go away, but then you still have all the privileges that do come with signing in with a Microsoft account. So that might be something worth trying. Anyway, I hope you found this helpful. Thanks for watching.